So, this scene was improvised. This scene was improvised. This one too. And this one as well. It's safe to say there's a lot of improvising that goes on in movies. For centuries, actors have improvised scenes to make them more realistic.
I love you.
I know.
Sometimes they turn out great, and sometimes they don't, but I guess we'll never know because they probably never ended up making the cut. One of the funniest scenes that I've ever seen being improvised was in The 40-Year-Old Virgin. Steve Carrel actually got waxed for this scene. This is dedication right here. I bet most actors would probably prefer to use fake hair or fake wax, but not him, not Steve Carrel. He's an actor who's always been dedicated to his craft. Well, clearly. What makes the scene even better is that the reactions from Seth Rogen, Paul Rudd, and Romani Malco are both completely natural. Here's a clip of Steve Carell talking about what all transpired.
I co-wrote that.
But you chose to write this scene for yourself, which is like, which was a form of self-loathing and...
Yeah, I thought it would be funny.
And it is.
I honestly
funny.
Respect
well,
that.
I thought it would be funny for the guys that were watching it in the scene. Because there's no way you can replicate that. There's no way you can act the horror that you're witnessing and the joy of watching a man go through something like that. And at one point, Romani Malco has to leave the scene because he's so utterly grossed out by the whole process.
For real?
For real. He has to leave.
I feel like if I was Seth Rogen, Paul Rudd, or Romani Malco, I would not be able to hold in my natural emotions. This is a great example of improvisation making for an even better scene, as it usually does. We as people love emotion and are especially good at being able to tell whether it's true or not. In this case, it's most definitely real and true. They're just watching one of their co-stars get waxed by a young lady. All of these factors make for a truly funny scene in the already funny 40-Year-Old Virgin.
Well, you look nervous. Is it the scars? You want to know how I got them?
Another scene that was improvised comes from the movie The Dark Knight. This is a personal favorite of mine. The Joker, played by Heath Ledger, who unfortunately passed away in 2008, left a remarkable mark on Hollywood after one of his most celebrated performances as The Joker. Throughout the movie, he actually had several scenes that were improvised that turned out to be legendary scenes we still marvel at till this day. One of his improvised moments came from when he slowly clapped at Gordon Ryan being promoted. Keep in mind, the rest of the cast had no idea he was going to do this. While this may seem like just a small touch, this happens at one of the movie's most pivotal moments when everyone feels like they've got the Joker figured out and the Batman wins. But clearly the Joker knows he has some more madness up his sleeve. In The Dark Knight, he also improvised another pivotal scene. There seems to be a common trend with Heath Ledger happening to improvise some of the key scenes of movies. Roll the clip. It's safe to say he got the remote control to work, however, it didn't come without its technical difficulties. The remote control in the scene actually didn't work, and this was Heath Ledger, well, the Joker's natural reaction to it being broken. Watching this back, it truly makes for an even more incredible scene that is a must-watch for all film enthusiasts like myself.
So serious.
Lay your palms flat on that tabletop. If you lift those.
At this moment, DiCaprio has actually just opened up his hand to some serious bleeding, but that didn't stop him from playing his part.
Around this dinner table here tonight, but that you can't believe. Mr. Moody, would you be so kind as to collect the pistol hanging off these boys' hips here?
This is why he's considered one of the best actors to ever do it. If this was me, I would have probably yelped, asked for a paramedic, or taken the day off, but not Leo. No, he went above and beyond with this one.
Y'all think my price? The this nigga here is too steep.
I'm kind of surprised the other actor in the scene let Leo rub the blood from his hand on him, but I guess it's DiCaprio, so he can kind of get away with this. At the end of the day, his improvisation really improved this scene and made it seem all the more real, which it was. When watching the scene back, it actually makes you respect all the more knowing he put himself through tremendous amount of pain and still was able to finish the scene. While some films are meticulously scripted, planned, others embrace improvisation to capture authenticity and creativity. There comes a time when the director and writers of a movie have to set aside their ego and just let the actors do what they do best, which is act. It's something that films have included in their movies for decades. There's a reason why audiences love blooper reels so much. It's mainly due to that feeling of authenticity and something we as a viewer can relate to. Filmmaking is a dynamic process where you should expect the unexpected. Improvisation allows for flexibility in responding to unforeseen circumstances, whether they be technical issues, weather conditions, or changes in the creative direction of the film. All of these qualities truly contribute to the film's overall realness. Is that even a word? Maybe, but you know what I mean. I hope you enjoy these moments that you may not have previously known were unscripted, and if you like this video, please feel free to like and subscribe, or comment down below scenes you think we missed or movies you would like to see included in future videos. From us here at Screen Therapy, we hope you have a great rest of your day.